Michelle Glass here. Our bone for today, there's actually two bones for today. We're going to be looking at the sacrum and the coccyx. So let's start with the coccyx, which is actually the very last bone of the vertebral column. The coccyx is what people commonly refer to as the tailbone, and it's just this small piece of bone here. Sometimes the coccyx is fused to the sacrum, as represented in this model here. Sometimes it stays as a separate bone. So I've actually wasn't able to find an example of the coccyx in the lab today, so we are looking at this model here to see the coccyx and then the sacrum here. Now the sacrum, this model is better representation, so let's use this model for the sacrum. So the sacrum here is going to be articulating with L5, which is the lumbar vertebra number 5, so that's going to be sitting here. And then of course the coccyx would be here. You are looking here at the posterior view, and this is the anterior view. As mentioned, this is the top or superior view. That's where L5 is going to rest. And then here would be the very bottom. That's where the coccyx would articulate. A lot of the features that we want to look for, you can see more from the posterior view. If you pay attention to this bone, you'll see that it looks like vertebrae that have fused together, which is how it's been formed. So you're going to see some of the same features and a few descriptions that are the same as what we had in the vertebrae. So to begin, we can look at what's called the median sacral crest. If you pay attention, this would be those spinal processes that have formed together to make the crest. This would be that vertebral foramen, but in this case, it's actually running all the way actually in front of the median sacral crest. So they filled it with plastic, but that would be a passageway for spinal nerves to extend through. That would be called the sacral canal. Where the canal ends, we call this the sacral hiatus. So a hiatus is an endpoint. You can see two lots of foramen. These would have been called, the intervertebral foramen on the vertebrae, but here we see them called the sacral foramina, which is many small foramen. This is going to allow for spinal nerves to stick through, and I'll show you that on another model here in just a few minutes. We have sticking up superior articular processes, so that's the same terminology that we used for our vertebrae. And then here, where L5's body would rest, this is called the promontory. So this whole thing here. On our lateral view, we have what's called the auricular surface. The auricle is the name for this outer part of your ear. So the auricular surface looks a little bit ear-shaped. And of course, you'd have that on both sides. Now, the auricular surface is where the bone of the pelvis is going to articulate. So your pelvis bone, we're going to be learning that a little bit later, has three distinct regions, one of which is called the iliac. So where the iliac region articulates with the sacrum, we're going to call that the sacroiliac joint. So you can see that here on this small skeleton. So sacroiliac joint implies bones connected to bones. So you would have to have an articulated skeleton in order to see that joint. You can see on this model too, where we have the spinal nerves sticking out through those sacral foramina. That's it.